But then there's a methodology today. Of course, we call this the higher criticism. And then in higher criticism, there are several of these methodologies. Let me just give you one example. This higher critical method called reduction criticism. Listen to how it works. Reduction criticism is the theory that different copyists and commentators of the early biblical writings embellished. Ano ibig sabihin ng embellished? Dinagdagan, no? Dinagdagan. And then altered. Ano ibig sabihin ng altered? Binago, dagdag bawas, no? May dagdag bawas sa salita ng Panginoon. The biblical text throughout early Jewish and Christian history to make them appear more miraculous, inspirational, and legitimate. So that means with this methodology, when you approach the Bible, when you read your Bible, there's already an assumption, something is wrong here. May dinagdag dito, may binawas dito. I need to find out, ano yung dinagdag, ano yung binawas, before I can learn something from this. Therefore, you question the validity of the Bible. And so friends, reduction criticism reduces the quality of the biblical record, casts strong doubt on its inspiration, and implies that the Bible is not trustworthy as a historical document. Now, we're not trying to say that all methodologies from the higher criticism are without value. Obviously, they have value. But what we're only saying here is you need to be careful. Not all methodologies are created equal. All right? You need to find out what's the bias behind this methodology.